Wow. I could actually make a super light jump from in atmosphere. In a lot of settings, they tell you do not McFucking do that. I remember that was a major plot point in the Battlestar Galactica reboot. The Galactica makes a FPL jump into the atmosphere of a planet. When it is not an atmospheric ship, like, it basically starts falling out of orbit. It dumps all of its fighters and then jumps back out before it hits the ground. Considered an absolutely insane maneuver in-universe, but it worked. Paizan said he got a Taco Bell ad.
Huh, neat.
Federal arms and crap. We build it, you finish it. I mean, like a Bethesda game. It's an actual store.
Alright. I will return in a little bit.
A brief visit from the Malkin.
Yeah. Shall return.
Are you going back out?
To walk a dog.
Walk a dog.
Yeah, walk a dog.
Dog walk. Yeah, that.
Dog. Alright, I'll be back. Dog.
I see, perhaps for player convenience, that my ship does not handle any differently in atmosphere. Yeah, color. Snow color. It's the first time I found a new window color. Might look nice. Yeah, that'd be interesting. Hey, there's a Billy in here. Annihilator virus. Sounds mean. Is it? I'll go back over and check. Another mainframe expansion. There should be a way into this wreck, but not immediately obvious. Not getting any interaction indicators on my HUD either. I think I found the generators in that other one. It definitely looks like a landing site. I have the feeling we'll be coming back here for a quest or something. These give a shine. Ooh, I'm gonna need to complete one more location challenge. It's a lot of regions in Cedo because of blueprint or medium nanobots. Micro. His stations off World Refinery. Because no one wants their processed atheum to be stored on a planetary surface. Not after what happened to Palamon. This is Palamon, by the way. yeah, I've been playing for more than 13 minutes. The stream might have dropped out when that ad rolled. Seems to do that now. You may not have noticed it from your end because the ad played. Another blueprint. Ooh, Gauss cannons. At least of the common variety. Oh. What would I do with this? Hold to extend and align. I think I might know what's happening here. I think I might need to bounce the mining lasers off these panels. Oh. I bet I need to blow that asteroid first. Let's see. Detonator. Detonator. Detonator, or just there. Now unobstructed. turn around here. Oh man, physics puzzles. Yeah, there we go. Oh, oh shit. What do I need all this Klygon for? That is. Takes care of that. I was pretty sure for a second that laser was going to fry me, but all's well that ends well, I suppose. Takes care of that. Alright. It's time to stop fucking around and go to Nephthys Plains.
Station is under attack.
Main Hub? Come in, Main Hub. We are in a bit of a pickle here. Please send... Oh, who am I kidding? Rotti, Agneta, everyone. We're doing this alone, people. Hey, need help? Oh, thanks, Sol. Reinforcements. And just in the nick of time, these scoundrels are pummeling us. All right, here we go.
Give him the zap.
Steady now, Dennings. Take aim before you... Ah, yes, that's much better. Four bags of crisps to whomever gets me that scout. Well done, you lot. I can see the sky again. Carry on scouting the perimeter while I have a chat with our visitor. Sir, if you don't mind docking here, I'd like to have a word.
Seen outlaws coming this close to G&B turf.
Indeed. Say, you look familiar. You've been here before?
No, I'm a wingman from Alcyone Station. We had a bit of server trouble, so I was ordered to come here and get a fresh batch of jump keys.
So you weren't sent as reinforcement? Oh, those blasted bureaucrats. There is a tandem squad of outlaws at our doorstep, and all management cares about is a fresh batch of jump keys. I'm sorry to inform you, but you were sent on a fool's errand. The only keys we were given are reserved for my own people.
There are none left?
None whatsoever.
Not even if I was to take care of your outlaw problem?
Well, in that case, I might be able to think of something. Before you leave, have a look at our ship loadout. There may be something that catches your eye.
Ooh. Different ships. This is the first time I've found a ship dealer. Total of 9 different ship classes. Class dependent alt, random set of class specific passives. Sentinel was a medium ship? Could have fooled me. Striker. Like, quickly engaging multi-target entanglements. Striker class fighter prioritizes damage output as more enemies enter the fray. No specialized thrust generation gets you there. Huh. More weapon damage for each enemy within 500 meters, up to 30%. Quantum Tether ult. Ooh. Damage sharing link. Get half my armor back when activating Quantum Tether. Also one less consumable, but one more primary and holds two more cargo. Tempest A1. Vindicator. Reconstitutes battlefield wreckage into drones. That dude wasn't kidding the other day. It is a necromancer. Little room for armor. Lot more cargo space. One less secondary weapon. Reanimator. Destroyed enemies may leave behind a wreck. 9 more cargo slots on this Vindicator. It says Vindicators have less armor overall, but it still has more armor than my Sentinel. Slower, though. Shield capacity, increased shield capacity, but which is reduced by 20% for each active drone. Greatly increase drone fire rate and synchronize them to attack your locked target. Temporarily respawns any missing drones for the duration of the effect. Drones have passive hull regeneration. Sounds worth it for the cargo space alone. What else have we got? Look at this little thing. Scout type. Ranger special. More damage from a distance. Shadow Strike ult. Huh. Got the Mass Effect Infiltrator style of cloak. Ooh. Massively decreased primary weapon spread. Less cargo space. Stinger. Ice Master. Oh. +1 to all device levels. Sets device cooldown. Release a swarm of aggressive microbots. Consume everything in their way. Restore hull and armor based on total damage dealt. Ooh-wee. Less cargo space. Wants a striker as well. Vanguard. Huh. Weird that a Vanguard, something called a Vanguard, would be the light type. Huh. Overcharges shields when flying faster than normal. Time slow ultimate. bomber. Secondary weapons use energy. Holy shit. Holds 3 secondary weapons. More cargo space. Arc 9000. Oh, it's got a BFG. Why is this Vindicator uncommon? Better stats? It's held back from damage. I forgot that the expertise stat affects different ships differently. Boost speed on the Striker. Drone hit points and damage on the Vindicator. Backstab damage on the That's interesting. The Vanguard has backstab damage, but the Scout has weapon range. Okay. I guess it's more of a sniper. Additional hardpoint duration. I don't like how that one looks, honestly. That's a different Sentinel. Interceptor. The Colonial Fleet's original workhorse. Weapons use boost energy after weapon energy is depleted. Has one more primary and secondary weapon slot, but one less consumable. Weapon overdrive ultimate. Boosted damage, fire rate, and unlimited energy. Kills extend duration. And so many options. Gunship. Uses 4 primary hardpoints, effectively doubling both damage and energy consumption. Automated turret ultimate. Reduced armor damage from expertise. 2 less consumables. 6 more cargo slots. 1 more primary weapon slot. All of these sound, a lot of these sound really fun. Other ship-specific achievements are there? Not the one for the Sen. I don't know if there are any. Unless they're in the hidden achievements. I'm figuring those are plot related. you go with one of these uncommon ships. In which case, I'm very tempted to try the Vindicator. Purchase options.
Let's take this for a spin.
Tempest A1 Vindicator. Huh. Now all of a sudden they have a rare Vindicator for sale. Holds a third device. Well, I cannot afford that at the moment. Let's see. Hooray for extra cargo space. Let's see here. Ah, I can use my saved pellet. Modules unlocked for the Tempest. And I didn't check what the new one I had for the Sentinel was. I had different wings. Oh well. Perhaps another time. I also get Beck interaction range. Jobs. quantum entangler. I already have one of those. Huh. Flicker sells good here. A lot of small arms. Ramen sells good here as well. Jobs.
Advisor transferred data concerning two nearby mines, each harboring about half a dozen rapscallions. Got it. Just leave it to me. Wonderful! And Godspeed. They made themselves at home here. Even had time to put up a missile silo.
I can manually construct drones if I find wreckage. Friend. Hydrate routine.
this is going.
New friends.
I've been detected.
Repulsor device. Pushes the target towards the aim direction. Target receives 100% increased collision damage for 5 seconds. Target's level must not exceed your own level plus 2. Charges. Says this feels very close to Outlaw Star levels of sci-fi world building, and I'm here for it. I guess we're supposed to dock a point for not having catgirls.
Heard a report of cat crime.
That was half a dozen.
Hey, Malcolm.
What's up?
Got a new ship.
Let's see.
It's a drone carrier. That dude from before is right. It is actually a necromancer class. You can spawn drones from wreckage left behind by destroyed enemies.
Oh, that's cool.
It gets a shield bonus, based on how many of your drones are missing. You can have up to 5. And it's all just, how does that actually work? It buffs their fire rate and forces all of them to attack your current target, and will temporarily spawn any missing drones for the duration. I learned a bunch about the other ship classes while I was shopping. There's a bomber class that, if you're using a bomber, any of your secondary weapons use energy instead of limited ammo. So they just regenerate. Meanwhile, there's a gunship type that basically doubles the shots of any primary weapon you're using. I think there's 9 total, so I get the sense that there's 3 light, 3 medium, and 3 heavy. One of the lights can cloak, and it gets the Mass Effect Infiltrator, like, damage buff, like, fire from cloak thing.
Hey, you! This cave is ours now.
Because you killed everyone inside? In that case, shouldn't it be mine now?
It's a blasted vicious circle.
NFT station? Expect things to be a lot calmer from now on.
Thank you. We're in your debt.
I'm glad I could help. Heading back to your place now.
I like how they fly in formation when you're in cruise drive.
So, about those keys.
This is highly unofficial, but There is a decommissioned jump gate at the Charybdis junkyard that may contain old key signatures.
I was hoping for a more straightforward solution.
It is indeed a dubious solution, but for a dubious character. You see, while you were gone, I ran a background check. Your name is Adam Roslin. You are a fugitive sought by the Colonial Fleet.
Scrap. Didn't expect a G&B officer to be so diligent.
Well, we have a bit of time on our hands out here. I also learned that you were a wingman assigned to Greg Callahan's squad. A wingman who apparently died defending a doomed engineer.
Just because Callahan abandoned him didn't make him doomed.
And that is precisely why I am helping you. Because in management's eyes, we too are a lost cause. The yields in Ceto are drying up. Director Blakemore is making more profit from our life insurance than from what we actually mine. Everyone should get out while they can.
I'll search the junk gate for those key signatures then.
At Charybdis Bowl, yes. And should you require some additional funds, we have a few assignments on the job board.
Sounds good. Thanks, and good luck.
Likewise, Mr. Roslin. Out here, we all need it.
Yeah, it was nice of that dude not to rat us out. Finding those hadron buffers yet. As I suspected, the main quest is taking us back to the Charybdis Bowl. We might see him again. I've seen a couple characters more than once already. A de-stress call. Drone number 5. Say hello to my little friend, and my little friend, and my little... etc. All my fellas.
All the smellers.
Oh yeah, DeWint. He seemed like that kind of character. Some medium nanobots? I do.
Man, you are like my guardian angel.
I do what I can for a fellow traveler. Signatures.
Crap, junkie. That's gotta be pretty big, I think. Thank you. That might be it over there. Here we go.
Just junk? Guess someone beat me to it. Great. Now what? Huh? A jump suppressor. Where did that come from? Find a single suppressor in this junk.
It's this wreck. One we couldn't get into before. Maybe now we can. Yeah, this door is conspicuously open now.
And...
Uh-oh.
Someone clearly doesn't want me to leave. Today.
Funny how it just looks like a really big car battery. That there. The other way.
That's it. I'm out of here.
Please, don't G-O-U.
Huh? Who is this?
I need your parts.
Right, but so do I. You know, this is a junkyard. Why not look for spares that aren't attached to people?
Computing request. Request accepted. IWWW-WILLELOUKFF for spares that aren't attached from PPP people.
Nice. The signal's coming from near the jump gate. Maybe that bot knows what happened to the gate's key module.
Fucking text-to-speech robot. Now you mention it, previously met Bison, it does kind of look like there should be six drones in the formation shape. Maybe one of the, maybe a high level vindicator has extra drones. See, now we can land here.
Welcome to Charybdis Recycling Plant, where your garbage is our future. How may I help you?
I'm looking for a jump gate module that can generate new jump keys.
Computing request. Only head management at HQ can generate and activate new key codes. If you are an employee of Grady and Brunt, please direct all code requests to HQ.
HQ? That's not even in this system. You're saying that everyone who isn't part of the company cannot leave CETO?
Exempt our colonial military off. Off, off, off. Turn in off all systems.
Wait, what about the military?
Colonial officials may use their military override to access jumping facilities.
A military override, huh?
Pyrrhus. I need PAR. Thank you for having visited Charybdis Recycling Plant. Where your garbage is our few
Poor guy. But time to head back to Dax.
This has been a bit of a runaround. Wonder how the hell we're gonna get out of this system.
Place where we will most definitely find one, but it won't be easy.
That pause is on you now.
Your friend just emerged from cryo.
Ben, he's awake?
No, the other one. Get your ass back here.
Dax!
Paralyzing darts. Your lab here has everything. So you hijacked my transport and brought me here. Not much I can figure out. You left me unattended, so you're obviously not that smart. He's fine. He'll just have a bit of a headache when he wakes up. Firstly, I'm going to give you this local muscle relaxant so you can move your jaw. Then, I want you to talk. If you don't give me satisfactory answers, I will use this syringe, which will put you to sleep indefinitely. Blink if you understand. Okay, so where the hell am I?
Cedar system, DMZ.
God damn it. So those bastards really did send me to the DMZ. This is all I need. So you're outlaws?
Not quite. Free agents.
How many more of you?
Just the three of us.
Yeah, I saw the poor guy in the next room. Raiding medical convoy something you do often?
First time.
The hell?
Welcome back. Are you going to cause trouble? Your companion here has been filling me in on a few details. You know, you should never hijack a lady without her consent.
You're unintended cargo. We're only after the meds.
Well, I'm not sure what meds alone will do to help your friend in the cryo. Those are third and fourth degree burns. He'll need operating on. You weren't planning on doing it yourselves, were you?
We're just doing what we think is right.
Well, I'm a medic first and foremost, so I'm offering to save your friend. If you can get me back out of the DMZ afterwards. This is not where I need to be.
Look, we'll bring you back to GMB. Apologies and all.
No thanks. G and B are in my bad books now. Perhaps I should have read the small print in the contract. I had no idea I'd end up in the DMZ.
Okay. Yeah, we can come to an arrangement. No small print.
Okay, then. Well, you two can scrape yourselves off the floor while I get to work. And no funny business, okay?
I have to admit, I like her style.
I'm Delia, by the way. Dr. Delia Wendo.
Call me Dex, and that's Adam.
So, which one of you brought me into this mess?
That was me.
That puts you in the pilot seat when I fly back out.
Don't worry. You and I have the same goal here. But first, we need to find a military override to get past the jump gate.
You got a plan for that?
Actually, we might. Adam, have you ever heard of the Cedo Ghost Fleet?
Can't say that I have.
It's a graveyard of old war wrecks, hidden by those Bloodstar idiots. It's a treasure trove of scrapped military tech, bunker casings, cruiser engines.
Hive units?
Exactly. Problem is, it's hidden by distractor tech, so no one ever found it.
So, more beanbags?
Nah, that's not outlaw style. They're more like fortified bases. That'll make them easier to find, but a hell of a lot tougher to take down.
Where do I start looking?
In the deep fields, I already uploaded some cords to your map. Once all the three bases are down, the Ghost Fleet will make its grand entrance and present us with our ticket out of Cedo.
Well, I'm glad you two got it all figured out. I'll gather some data on my patient, while you free agents get busy raiding bases.
We're really not outlaws.
And I really don't care. We're good. As long as you uphold your end of the bargain.
A party member of sorts. What do you love Dax for, Paizo? The I like her style comment. Perks does she offer? Nanotechnology. And energy. Ooh, interesting. Destroying ships will sometimes set free energy orbs that replenish some weapon boost energy when collected. Good thing I've been picking up a lot of these flawless Athium crystals. Probably not in this region. There's something I need copper for. That's a lot of credits. I like that word. Vindicator. Sounds good. Hunt that ghostly.
The markers show all bases I detected within the deep fields. A few may be duds, but I'm certain at least one of them is a beanbag hiding the ghost fleet. Once you've found it and taken it down, I'll use a little trick to pinpoint the others.
Safe.
That includes not revealing to her that you're a clone. I know by now you're just a regular dude and all, but there's a lot of resentment against clones in the colonies.
You don't have to remind me. Not even Ben knows.
Better keep it that way.
To get hurt. They won't know what hit him.
Let's try. I don't know what kind of narrative this is yet in that regard.
Breezy. Not Breezy. Bison.
Fucked up. Abort. I don't know if this is one of those anyone can die stories or not. I don't have that sense as of yet. Is. And if there is one, if there's a way to keep getting device upgrades. Thank you. shipwreck over there, though.
Something about it.
Can you remember using the shoulder cannon on what the fuck is his name in Borderlands the pre-sequel?
Oh, well.
Yeah. Just come out and he'd be like, "I love this guy."
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Yeah, I like these drones. They're all right.
That is just what I need.
Phalanx comes back pretty quick, too. Whoa. One of those Bloodstar overseers. Not destroy all of its armor. Huh. Uncommon booster. Mayhap the Vindicator is not conducive to this particular challenge. Ship paint. Sunburn missing. Oh.
I'll be first to shoot it down.
Another blueprint. Or sticky turrets.
You're on to me.
It needs space. More space.
Master.
Common, I think. Yeah. Yeah. They seem very nice to have around. It alleviates the yield issue of being outnumbered by AI enemies. Somewhat. Drones. Oh, in this color. Play, there's a bunch of wreckage around here. I believe they either slow or stop opposing ships. I've been hit by Weber drones that limit my movement.
Look out for?
If it's a beanie, it should have some dome-like structure attached to it.
But even then, you'll need to blow the whole thing up to be certain.
It's an outlaw base, all right, but let's see a dome. Must be one of the duds.
Oh, shit.
That didn't take long.
It's like my laser is pulsing on its own.
Is it supposed to do that?
I mean, ideally.
Yeah, we'll carry on then.
Oh, okay.
I was looking for a professional opinion on the subject.
Technically.
Technically.
Considering that lasers. Are made out of waves of energy. Those oscillate. Technically, they are pulsing on their own.
Does that mean any laser is a pulse laser? I just thought that meant like. Instead of a continuous beam, like staggering the activation.
I mean, I guess you could do that.
Like just,
you're gonna be real
just a sequence of like quick, well, pulses, basically. A burst, if you will.
Yeah.
Because I think when video games say pulse laser, that's what they mean. Can't really handle being hit by detonator drones. I guess that makes sense. Can map out the rest of Cito. Get that trap bonus.
sun orbit.
To the sun here, but hell of a view.
I can't see anything.
Hello? Anyone home?
Huh? Who are you?
I was just passing through, hoping for some quick repairs and maybe some provisions.
You don't happen to be from the Union system, do you?
No, I'm from here.
But you must know someone in Union, right? You are a freelancer. You have a network.
Calm down, okay? Just tell me what's wrong.
I've been trying to contact our sister station at the Gauntlet. Something's off. I can't reach them.
I'm actually heading that way. You want me to check on them?
Yes, yes, definitely. They were onto some very important research. Vital in so many ways you wouldn't understand. Here are the coordinates. Let me know once you get there.
All right. But first, let me take care of my ship.
Of course.
Madness. Let's see. Interestingly enough, small arms are in demand in this area. Suppose there are a lot of pirates out here.
Come on.
Boulder Crystal. Obsidian. Sounds like what you'd use to power a cloaking person. Another poop. I'm gonna call the energy cores. Fear one heavy. And I have acquired a heavy root.
Finally.
Deposits is inside the tree.
Let's take care of that base.
Asparagus window color?
Yeah, okay.
They can't all be gems, I guess. max out the energized boost. Now I got a choice of notes. Leaves enemies webbed. Double speed boost, half duration. Or also pass enemies, deals kinetic and energy damage and pushes them away. Yes, let's try high pressure. Not sure which of those is the most useful at present. Guess it's time to start upgrading other devices. Got a ship color and a blueprint over here. Ooh, cold heat primary color. It looks like the dark red that I'd like to use. Ooh, common Gauss can. Very interesting. Perfect spot for a secret stash. Only it didn't end up on everyone's radar.
There you are. A nice railgun. Reconfigured asteroids for detonation. Thank you. Yeah, level. That's what I was thinking. Level it out to the galactic plane. This region way over here. In space. Fair enough.
Looks like another trap. Shouldn't leave without teaching him a lesson.
Thank you. a bunch of purple items that I cannot use yet. Actually purple items. Maybe the purple just means I can't use them. They're not actually, Yeah, no. Purple's not actually a quality color in this. Cito signal. When activated, reveals a high-risk area in the current region of the Cito system. 100% more loot quality. Enemies have 50% more loot speed. visit all of Cedo's regions.
My ship is pretty damaged. Can you help me? I'll see what I can do. Spread some of the goodwill around.
He's one of those overseers. See if I can take out those armor plates. Different ship for that challenge. Get very close to the sun. Okay then.
Unless I do something about it.
close do they want me to get? Oh, that close. Unlocked TV function color.
Welcome back.
Oh, looks nice. Though I do like the twin engine setup on the Type 1. I gotta go to the bathroom real quick. I will be back. Thank you. return.
Resource-rich area.
blueprint. Nice.
Surrounded by hostiles and taking fire. Request immediate assistance.
Was lost somewhere around these coordinates.
That you can boost in any direction. Not a typical feature. What the hell is this? We're supposed to... What's this? Aha! Painter's found. Bring it to Nepthes Station.
Thank you. damage to my craft?
I'll take a look.
Wings for the Vindicator. A common scattergun blueprint. Oh shit. I'm being raided. Funny looking for a... Wait a minute, did I not change the goddamn... Son of a bitch.